What's up, guys? My name is Tef. I'm a singer-songwriter, and today we're going to be unboxing Roland's Go Mixer Pro X. Let's get started. So right off the bat, love the packaging. It tells me everything I need to know right on the front. The Roland Go Mixer Pro X promises to be one of the best tools out there for musicians on the go without sacrificing sound quality. Let's open this thing. I love the attention to detail in this packaging. Let your music go places. Very cute. Pretty straightforward packaging. Now let's review what's inside. First things first, you get the Go Mixer Pro X. Obviously. Next, we have the USB-C to USB micro cable. If you're an Android user and your phone has a USB-C port, then this is the cable you'd be using to connect to your Go Mixer Pro X. If you don't have a USB-C port, you can still connect to the Go Mixer Pro X using the 3.5mm cable included in the box. If you're an iOS user, don't feel left out. There's also a Lightning to USB micro cable included. And finally, we have our safety manual and instructions on how to download a PDF version of the owner's manual. All right, some first impressions. Love the matte black. It's a beautiful product, really well made, seems very sturdy, incredibly light. It's portable. What else can you ask for? On the right side, looks like we get a combo microphone input for an XLR or quarter-inch cable. It also looks like they give us a phantom power switch, which then allows us to power any condenser microphone we may want to use. You also have a smartphone input, which can be used as a two-way connection to your phone. And lastly, we have a mono quarter-inch input. Lots of flexibility. Moving on to the next side, we have our battery switch. Or you could also power up your Go Mixer Pro X using the provided USB micro cables for your phone. Otherwise, you can always use the batteries. Speaking of batteries, you have your battery compartment here. It takes 4 AAA batteries. Make sure this little cap is screwed all the way in and you're good to go. You also get 2 more quarter-inch inputs here, which is great if you have a source with a stereo output. Moving on to this little front panel, looks like we have a ton of stuff here. There's a loopback switch in the case you want to jam out with something playing on your phone. Otherwise, leave it off. Next, we have a 3.5 headphone jack, pretty straightforward. We also have a pad switch for the quarter-inch input located on the right side of the Go Mixer Pro X. As if that wasn't enough, you also have 2 stereo 3.5mm inputs. Keep in mind though, that these don't have a dedicated volume control, so you would have to control the volume from the source. Moving on to the top, we've got dedicated volume controls. Each of these knobs are clearly marked by an icon that represents the inputs and outputs that they're controlling. And did I mention they're silky smooth? Because they are. All in all, a really flexible product, tons of options. They even have a spot to hold your phone, so you don't even need a tripod. What? Amazing. Now that we know what it looks like, let's see what it sounds like. So there you have it, the Roland Go Mixer Pro X. Awesome product, awesome build, awesome sound. I definitely recommend it for those who might be on the road, who like to live stream, people who do podcasts, who would like to record on their tablets, on their phones. This little device allows us to get the best quality sound out there. So thanks for watching, and if you do get the Roland Go Mixer Pro X, or if you already own it, I would love to hear your thoughts. Leave a comment, tag me in any of your work. I would love to hear it. I would love to connect with you, and I'll see you around. Bye.